Hey guys, this is Mike again from Mike's Outdoor Stuff. I'm here with Steve, my buddy Steve. We got the tent set up. I think you saw it in my last video. We're here in the beautiful state of Idaho, right next to the Snake River. My voice is a little bit raspy, so I apologize for that. So that's why Steve's gonna be helping doing some of the talking, some of the chopping and setting stuff up. What we got today is gonna be the Wild West titanium backpacking stove, and this is what we got here. And we're gonna set that up with the Octopeak, the 6P tent that I got from Luxe Hiking Gear. So there it is. Comes in this nice box. Yeah, we don't use instructions.
No.
We don't need these.
Those are overrated. This is the chimney. That's kind of cool.
Stainless.
But let's set it together here. Like we did the tent, we're just kind of winging it, looking at the parts, seeing how they go together. It's got these channels. Okay, and you slide it in. Oh, that's beautiful. I like it. Pretty simple. So these are gonna be the legs. So we'll take her easy. We'll just take it up one by two. Then it's got a little wing nut on the bottom. You just tighten those up. Better look. So then you just tighten these up in here. It's kind of tricky to find the.
There it is.
Just tighten the wing nut.
Self-leveling.
So here we go. I think the hard part's done. Let's see what's in here. Nothing. So like this is the spark arrestor and the dampener. Oh, hang on to that. So yeah, so these, you essentially just tighten these in right here. You slide that in. And then you twist it and then you just tighten it down. Cool. There you go. If you guys remember from my last video, this was that piece that you just put on there, Velcro. It's a fire or heat resistant material. And it looks like it didn't come with any cuts for the chimney. So we're gonna have to do that. We're just gonna wing it because I don't know. It doesn't really say how big or anything to cut it. Or does that say anything?
Well, that's how big the chimney is.
Yeah, let's see. So this is gonna be the flap that's gonna come on it like that. So I would almost say, kind of do it like so. What do you think? Yeah?
Yeah, I think that looks perfect.
Kind of like right in there. Now, a lot of people recommend wearing gloves when you do this because I guess you could get cut. But again, we're wild. We're just gonna do it. Oh, that was quick. Okay, so what we gotta do with this, you got all those rings.
I do.
So it might be easy to have a friend help you out first. Now just be careful. Give me a couple of those rings. So yeah, you kind of just roll it. Yeah, just be careful, try to keep it.
So there actually is plenty of room for the ring, so you don't have to get it super tight.
No, correct.
So. All right, I think that's...
Yeah.
Maybe space them out equally so you get...
That's right. Space them out so it looks amazing. How's which that? I think it looks amazing.
That's pretty amazing. What do you think?
Okay. Yeah, and see, then you can kind of move it like that.
All right.
20 minutes, that worked great. Okay, let's get, you want to hold that?
Yes, sir. See how the precision cut is working out. Oh my gosh, like, uh-oh.
Uh-oh, what? Oh.
Make sure, I'll just feed the rings through.
Okay. So these things come with a pad. Obviously, I don't have one right now. And what I'm gonna do instead is I'm gonna put a couple pieces of wood on the bottom just to hold the legs. There we go. Just for now. Let's take a look at it from outside. That looks awesome. Okay, so we're gonna get this fire started, see how the burning process goes. I made these wax and cotton fire starters that we're going to use, and I can kind of show you how we did those later. But we're gonna use those and put the little pieces of wood in there to get her going.
Got a good little fire going.
Yeah. So what this has, this is your essentially your intake, your air intake. So if you want the fire to get nice and hot, you leave it wide open and it'll burn really hot. Then if you want to choke it down a little bit, you kind of shut these vents right here. That's your oxygen going in. And then your exhaust, obviously, on your chimney. So like if you're going to sleep at night, you probably want to choke it down a little bit just so you have a longer burn, because this will burn it. If you have it fully open, it'll burn through your wood pretty dang quick. You choke it down a little bit, and you can kind of see the flames dying down a little bit because it's choking it down. So let's get a good fire going here. So we'll open it right up, cook on there, warm stuff up, have a nice tea, whatever you want, coffee.
So I would say, as far as simplicity goes, this is about as simple as it gets. And it's hot in here.
It's hot in here. Yeah, it's probably about, I don't know, I'd say 50, 55 degrees outside, blowing a little bit. But yeah, we're pretty toasty in here. Even with the door open, it's almost sweating temperature yet.
It's a sweat lodge.
Yeah,
it's definitely a sweat lodge.
Yeah. But it works great, though. It works really, really good. Yeah, I mean, the whole setup, even if you're going... This is sold as like a backpacking or deep backcountry hunting type setup. And the whole thing combined is about 8 pounds weight in your pack. So it's not bad at all. Titanium wood stove, nice lightweight, you know, no floor deal. So you can see me and Steve here, we're sitting here just fine, you know, a couple of camping chairs and whatnot. You know, have a couple more room for, actually probably a couple more guys too if you wanted in here. You know, I could see they were saying originally it was a 3-person with the wood stove. So one person can probably sleep there, one person here, one person here. So yeah, I could see that, definitely a 3-person. But like if you didn't have this wood stove in here, yeah, you can get quite a bit more people in here. It says a 6-person tent, but
oh, yeah, nice.
Not bad.
So what would you say as far as ease of use?
I mean, we fumbled a little bit with the stove pipe there, but, or the chimney. But ease of use is actually really easy to put together. I think that chimney just takes a little bit of practice, and then you'll get it going pretty easily. But I've other reviews I've actually read myself, they essentially say once you get it set up the first time, it's after that it's gonna be a lot easier to set up.
I would say there's probably a slight learning curve, but I mean, we first time doing it, I'd say that was pretty simple.
Pretty simple, yeah, I would agree.
So. And effective, so, and it's hot. It's getting hotter.
Yeah, it's getting really hot. So, yeah, we're just going to wait. We didn't put a whole lot of wood in there, so we're just going to wait till it burns out and then pack her up and we're out of here. Thanks for watching. See you next time.